Languages, Concept, Unit 4. By the end of this video, you should be able to describe and give examples of different types of conflicts that occurred in the Middle Ages. Examples of this would include military, religious, and economic conflicts. Middle Ages is really an age of conflicts. It begins with the fall of Rome due to invasions from surrounding tribes. These early conflicts continued as groups attacked Europe from three sides. Vikings invaded from the north. The Magyars, who become the people of modern-day Hungary, invaded from the east, and the Muslims from the south. Because of this constant state of warfare, both from invasions and from people within competing for land and power, that's how the feudalism system developed. People were looking for protection. And the lords who owned these manors, these large areas of land, built massive castles with really thick walls as fortresses for defense. Some of the military developments during the time period included the use of saddles and stirrups to help knights stay on their horses when they were fighting. Defenders of castles would pour boiling water, hot oil, or molten lead on their enemies as they tried to scale or breach the walls. Crossbows were used that could pierce through armor. Siege towers, like the one you see in the picture here, were built so that armies of knights could scale the walls and get inside the fortress of the castle. Also, as attackers advanced on the castles, they used large shields to give them cover, including things known as mantlets and fortresses. Battering rams were developed to actually break down the walls, and there were a number of catapult devices that were in use so that you could launch things at a distance of 1,000 yards or greater to help attack and defeat these strongholds. Probably the most famous series of military conflicts in the Middle Ages are the Crusades. This is a series of European expeditions against Islamic power in the Middle East. Muslims were trying to defend their territory against European invasion, and Europeans were trying to conquer and take back what they considered to be Christian territory. The Crusades were really a combination of religious, territorial, and political conflict. It basically worked this way. A leader would issue an appeal for help, and then an army would be raised and people would go fight. Factors that led people to volunteer to fight in the Crusades were, first of all, the knights and vassals had no choice. If their lord, to whom they pledged allegiance, said fight, they had to. If the Pope issued a call for arms, then the fighting became a holy pilgrimage, and the participants believed that they could earn official forgiveness for sin by going on the Crusades and fighting. There were participants who were hoping they would get rich because they desired a share of the plunder or the treasure. There were merchants who were looking for new trade opportunities, and some people joined simply because they thought it sounded exciting and they had a desire to see other parts of the world. The Crusades were really a series of events beginning in the late 1000s and going to the early 1200s. The first crusade resulted in the establishment of four Christian states in the eastern Mediterranean, roughly in the area where modern-day Syria, Lebanon, and Israel are located today. And these were symbolic in that, for a time, Jerusalem was returned to Christian control, although doing so resulted in the massacre of a number of inhabitants. The second crusade was not very successful. The Europeans tried to retake Damascus, but could not. In the third crusade, Jerusalem had fallen back under Muslim control under a leader named Saladin. The campaign to regain Jerusalem was led by three of the most famous and powerful European leaders of the time: Richard I of England, also known as Richard the Lionhearted; Frederick Barbarossa of Germany; Philip II Augustus of France; they made a successful landing on the coast, but they couldn't press very far inland. Frederick actually drowned. Philip got mad and went home, and Richard was able to negotiate free access to Jerusalem for Christians, but he wasn't able to gain any more territory. The Crusades that came after this also were largely unsuccessful. This includes a children's crusade, where kids were recruited to go and fight in the territory, and most of those children either died along the way due to the conditions of marching, they were lost at sea, drowned, and shipwrecked, or were sold into slavery. The overall impact of the Crusades is that trade was expanded, but that was likely going to happen anyway. It increased the persecution of Jews and Muslims in Spain, but for the Jews across Europe, it made it more acceptable for people to target a group for religious reasons. It shifted the balance of power from nobles from the feudal system to kings who were forming stronger central governments, and it undermined the power of the Pope and the Church. There were other religious issues in this time period. Priests were marrying and having families, which was against the official Church doctrine. They were practicing something called simony, where bishops actually sold positions in the church rather than appointing people on the basis of qualifications. There was also a practice called lay investiture, which was the process by which kings could appoint bishops. It was giving a secular leader, the king, control over religious leaders, the bishops. This involved a lot of scandal and controversy. There was a pope named Gregory who wanted to end the practice, and a king named Henry IV of Germany who fought that very avidly, and all of that winds up in the issuance of a statement known as the Concilia of Bern, where it says that the church and not kings have the power to appoint bishops, but a king can veto those appointments. There was also a conflict when the Pope's home, the papacy, the seat of his power, was temporarily relocated to Avignon, France, for a period of almost 70 years. In that time period, when the Pope was centered in France and not Italy, not in Rome, one of the popes died on a visit to Rome. The cardinals elected an Italian, a Roman Pope, but they also elected a French pope shortly thereafter. So there was a period of time where there were two popes serving, and that's known as the Great Schism. The French followed the popes in France and Avignon, and the Italians followed the popes in Rome, and it took some time to get that resolved. The impact of all of this is that it weakened the church's influence and led many to call for reform. Also a period of economic struggle. Most people's image of the Middle Ages has to do with the lords of the manor, the castles, but they're really a small minority of the overall population. Most people struggled to survive. They were peasants, including people who were known as serfs. This is a specific category of peasants. These people were bound to the land where they were born. They could not leave. And while they weren't considered slaves because they couldn't be bought or sold, they really had very limited opportunities to do anything for their own benefit. Peasants and serfs owed their lords their labor and a portion of their harvest they paid almost as a tax. They had to pay taxes to grind grain at the lord's mill, to get married, but only with the lord's consent, and to the church, which was called a tithe, or 10% of their earnings. They lived in small, one or two room cottages, and they experienced a high degree of illness and malnutrition. Life expectancy for peasants was about 35. It's interesting that the Middle Ages end the way that they were started, with a war. And the war is called the Hundred Years' War between France and England. It actually lasted a little more than 100 years. It's a series of conflicts. And the most significant impacts of this war are the use of the longbow, which ended sort of this military age of knights and chivalry, the period in which Joan of Arc helped France become victorious, but she is martyred for her religious belief, and it results in a rise in nationalism. The people saw their king as a national leader, and it shifted power away.